So hello everyone, welcome to the session Symplectic and Method in Hydrodynamics. So our first speaker today is François Desmaux from EPFL.
Yes.
He will present multi-symplectic variational integrators for fluid models with constraints. Please.
Thank you for listening my talk. So I am going to speak about a multi-symplectic variational integrator for fluid. I will speak at first of space-time multi-symplectic variational mechanics in general, the main ideas, and after I will develop space-time discretizations, in particular of the Jacobian, and I will apply this discretization of the Jacobian to multi-symplectic geometry, and I will show you some results we got, and further topics. So the main ideas of space-time multi-symplectic variational mechanics is about in continuum mechanics, we have the multi-symplectic form formula, which is analog of the statements that the Lagrangian flow map is symplectic in classical mechanics. But in multi-symplectic, that is in field theory, we have the multi-symplectic form formula. It was proved by Marsden, Patrick, and Scholar in 1998. And moreover, we are using a variational structure. So we get also preservations of the symmetry. So we preserve the momentum. And we have a covariant Noether theorem, which is also proved by Marsden, Patrick, and Scholar. This is true in the continuum mechanics, but it is also true in discrete mechanics. And in all this work, it is based on the work of Gauthier and Marsden. There is three papers of Gauthier and Marsden. In fact, there are other scientists who work with Gauthier and Marsden, but I think it is more important people for this work. So all the ideas are based on this idea. So we start directly on discrete side. We don't speak of continuum side because we have not time, and all the ideas are developed in discrete side. So in this field theory, discrete field theory, we have discrete geometric setting, which is described as by a configuration bundle. In fact, it is a trivial bundle based on the space. We have the space time and the configuration bundle on the top, and there is also a parameter space, which is composed of the indices of coordinate in the space time. I will show perhaps this image. In fact, you have on the left, you have a parallelepiped. Thanks. So you have the indices here because if we go back, we have the parameter space, and it is a set of parallelepipeds. And the space-time is on the side, it is a parallelepiped with the positions in the space-time. So you have on the base, you have the positions in the space-time at time tg, and on the top, it is at time tg plus one. And on the left, you have the indices. So in first, we are going to link the links between parameter space and space time. And after, we will go to the parameter space and configurations bundle. And to define the Jacobian, we will look at the configurations bundle with respect to the space time. So in the space time, we need to define the metric. And this metric is, in this case, for simplification, is the identity. Because we are going to calculate the length of the space in the space-time. And so we need to have a norm and a metric. And this time we look at the indices and the configurations associated to the indices. That is, we look at the links between parameter space and configurations bundle. And we define the four vectors in each node. In, for example, the nodes A, B, G, at time TG, we have the four vectors. So it is the vector, for example, between phi A plus 1 B and phi A B at time TG divided. Yes, thank you. This one. We have these positions minus these positions divided by the length of the space in the space time. So we define the. Okay. And then we define a discrete deformations gradient for each parallelepiped. It is a kind of a tessellations of the space of the space time. So you have the first matrix defined by the two vectors F1 and F2. And after you have a second matrix defined by the vector F2 and F3, after the F1 and F4, and after F3 and F4. So we have the four matrix at time TG, and we have also four matrix at time TG plus one. Then we define the discrete Jacobians, which is only the determinant of the of this matrix. So we have, all these Jacobians are defined for a parallelepiped, only one parallelepiped. And so we have a set of parallelepipeds, and we define the Jacobian for all the parallelepipeds in the space-time, at time t1 to tn. After, due to the fact that we study fluid, we are going to indicate what kind of Lagrangians we are using for this fluid. We consider a barotropic fluid with a potential defined with respect to the density, mass density, and the Jacobian. And this in this paper, we consider this kind of potential for isentropic perfect gas with in particular, what is important? Oh. Yes, so we have two coefficients, R and B. And B defines the value of the pressures on the boundaries. So B, yes. Because the pressure is inside the fluid is has this value, and on the boundary it is only equal to B. So, for example, if the fluid is in the vacuum, for example, the B equals zero. If we want to use to define a fluid, a liquid, a water, for example, we are going to give to the value B the value of the pressure in the atmosphere. So we go back to the discrete mechanics, and in the discrete mechanics, in the field theory developed by Marsden, there is a jet bundle. The jet bundle, first jet bundle, it is a set of all the first derivatives. In this case, in discrete mechanics, it is not the first derivative, it is the positions on each node of the parallelepiped. So you have eight nodes on the parallelepiped, so you have the eight positions at time tg until tg plus one. And after we define the discrete Lagrangians in the same way as in continuous mechanics, and this time for barotropic fluid, we are going to sum the Jacobian on all the nodes of the parallelepiped. In fact, yes. And after we define the discrete action functional, which is a sum of all the Lagrangians with respect to the to G, that is to the time from zero to n minus one, for the positions A equals zero to A minus one, and to B equals zero to B minus one. We apply the variational principle and we get the discrete covariant Euler Lagrange equations. That is, it is in integrators if you want. So you get the positions at time g plus one when we know the positions at time g and g minus one. So there is a derivative, all these coefficients A, B, C, D, A, F, G, and H are given by the derivative by respect to the positions phi.
It's
not working.
Is it the next one or the
previous one? Previous one.
Okay, we can go like that.
Okay. Yes, you look at the derivative with respect to the positions phi A, B at time G and all these nodes. And this time we look at the, we define the Cartan form, discrete Cartan form. All the eight Cartan form are defined on all the nodes of the parallelepiped. It is, in fact, the first derivative, the derivative with respect to its positions. And we have these relations. It is a trivial relationship here with where V is the first variations of the solutions of the covariant Euler Lagrange equations. And so when we do the first the derivative of the actions, we get this solutions, and after we apply the exterior derivative to this derivative, and we get the discrete multisymplectic form formula, which is equal to zero due to the relations to the property of exterior derivative. So we get exactly the discrete multisymplectic form formula in the same way as in the continuum mechanics. And concerning the Noether theorem, we define we consider the actions of Lie group, for example, with respect to the symmetry of the system. And after we get the infinitesimal generator, and from the infinitesimal generators, we can go back for the variations and the variations. We instead of the variation VD, we consider the infinitesimal generator. Yes, and we get these relations which is equal to zero because the Lagrangian is a J invariant. So we get equal to zero. And after, we know that we define the momentum map by these relations, the pairing between the momentum map and the Lie algebra associated to the Lie group. And the Cartan form associated with the infinitesimal generator. And we get the discrete covariant Noether theorem. Note that this Noether theorem is defined only on the side, on the boundaries of the domain, because inside the domain, we have a covariant Euler Lagrange equation, so it is zero inside the domain. So the discrete covariant Noether theorem is defined on the boundary of the domain. And yes. So from these integrators, we did some tests in 2D, for example. So we have a fluid which is flowing on a surface in 2D and then one obstacle. So the obstacle we to consider to solve the problem of the obstacle, we are using a multiplicator of a penalty method, for example. And we did that also in 3D. It is a vacuum, so there is no gravity. And what you, if you look on the right side, you see the relative energy, which is it is 10 minus 3. So it is very well conserved, the energy. Moreover, the symmetry are perfectly conserved. We have all the symmetry. And we did also tests in 3D. And it is also a contact between a fluid flowing on the surface and a contact on, again, a wall, for example, an obstacle. So this, so it is a further topic because as we saw at the beginning, we use a metric which is identity in this case. In the space-time, the metric was identity and there is no deformations of the mesh. But the goal is to have an adaptive mesh, for example. So in this case, we need to have a metric which evolves with time. In this case, we did that test in 1D because we have the reference configurations which evolve in the same time as the configurations. And it is the mesh evolve with the configurations. And in this case, we introduce a metric and we have a perfect conservation of the momentum map of the symmetry and also the energy is very well conserved. And there is another subject. It is not finished. We must work on 2D and 3D also to introduce a metric also in the space-time. And we study also the connections between fluid and elastic body. In this case, the elastic body is considered in the same way as fluid, but instead of calculating the Jacobians, we defined a discrete Cauchy-Green deformation tensor, which is symmetric, and we get this result. So it is quite difficult in general to study the contact between fluid and elastic solid. And so we have also a very good result. The energy, I didn't show the energy, but it is well conserved also. But note that the contact between fluid and elastic solid is a very particular subject and we are not very, it is not finished this work because we have to consider the mesh. The mesh must be disconnected. Each cell of the mesh must be disconnected because there are very huge pressures at the level of the contact. So, all right. No. So the reference are, yes. The main reference, or the basic reference is Gauthier, Isenberg, Marsden, Montgomery, and Snitiki, and Yaskin, but the main person are Gauthier and Marsden. So we did some papers already concerning a beam based on the Lie group variational integrators. And there is a paper concerning variational integrators and the space-time simplicity, because we can go in space and after we can go reconstruct in time. We did that with this beam. You know, it is quite interesting because we got a very interesting result. I think impossible to get when we go in time. Sometimes it is surprising the results we get. And after we did this work with the contact mechanic, so it is also super. And after there is these papers are quite important also, the Liu, Marsden, Ortiz, and West. And yes, and Marsden, Bekarski, Scholar, and West, it is a paper where they study the fluid mechanics in continuum mechanics, but and so it was a viewpoint which was Lagrangian also. So I think it is the end of my talk.
Okay.
Thank you.